hello, Helen. Well, I'm just off to London. Do you think you could wait? Jenny, no. No, she's in London too. Yes, probably. Look, I'm afraid I've got to go. I've got a business appointment at 6. Tomorrow evening. No, of course I haven't forgotten. Yes, all right. I'll see you then. Bye.
Good evening, Mr. Hadleigh.
Good evening, Arthur.
James. What an unexpected delight. Will you join me? Or are you busy?
No, no, of course. I'd be delighted to, Charlie. Thank you.
Good. A scotch?
Yes, please.
A large scotch, Arthur, the way Mr. Hadleigh has it, and bring me some of my cigars, will you?
Of course, sir.
So you've got Arthur well trained?
Oh, I like this club, James. I'm glad you put me up for it. You look as if you've had a hard day. What have you been up to?
Well, I had to drive down and see some Germans about some tractors.
East or west?
East, Leipzig. I showed some interest at Olympia last week, and they won't let me forget it. They want me to go out next week, as a matter of fact.
Very nice. You taking Jennifer?
Oh, I don't know. I mean, would she enjoy it? Board meetings, lunches, tours of inspection.
Well, you'll get some hospitality as well. Things are loosening up out there. And Jennifer loves travel, new faces.
Yes, have you seen her recently?
Not for a week or so. How is she?
Oh, she's fine. I just thought she might have told you about the job she'd been offered.
God, do you have to do it now?
Sorry. But what else can I do? I'm at work. We're supposed to be out of here by Saturday.
Half the stuff isn't ours anyway.
It's all ours.
What, that?
Yes. Jen gave that to us when she got married.
Oh, yes, of course. Her wedding present. To us.
Oh, I do wish she'd phone. Look, didn't she phone this afternoon?
What about?
Her interview. Lunch at the Connaught. She promised she'd let us know.
She doesn't want to go to America. I don't believe it. How can she? This isn't a break, is it, James? This isn't a real breach. Is there anything I can do?
No, I don't think so, Charlie.
Well, I'll talk to her if you think it'll help.
No.
Look, what she wants is a firm hand. That's all she's ever needed.
Well, did she ever get it, Charlie?
Well, I never put her over my knee, if that's what you mean. It's hard without a mother being there. But America. Some sort of cry for attention, isn't it?
I've given her attention, Charlie. I've given her everything she wanted. That's not the problem. She doesn't know what she wants. I don't know what she wants. Well, we've got to find out soon. Or we go under. And that would be sad.
Be very sad for me, too. Where is she now? Are you meeting her?
Oh, would you excuse me? I've just got to make a phone call. Is that Professor Metcalf? It's James Hadleigh. Yes, I was. I was wondering if she was with you now. I see. Oh, no, please, don't. Well, it's not important. We must just have missed each other, I think that's all. You're not expecting her later on. I see. Well, no, don't bother, please. All right, thank you. Hello, Tony?
It's James. It's James Hadleigh.
Is Jenny with you?
Have you lost her?
Hello, James. It's Lois. Look, haven't you heard from Jen? Because we're terribly worried about her, too. Oh. Hello? Hello, James? James?
Well, perhaps she's phoned home or even be on her way there now. Can't you ring up and find out?
There's no one there.
Well, Well, Sutton's there?
A couple of days off. He's got his own problems.
Was that a bird in the village?
Yes, as a matter of fact, it is. The doctor's wife. She's left her husband.
Good God.
No, 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 no. It's not like that. She's just gone off to Cornwall for a couple of days. He's gone after her.
It sounds like carnage up there. Arthur?
Sir?
More drink, please. But thinking about you and Jennifer, they always say, you know, that you should treat a business deal like a woman. Nurse it along, nurture it, keep looking ahead. Well, I think you want to deal with this problem like a business transaction.
It's a bit heartless, isn't it, Charlie?
Not a bit of it. Is it heartless in business when you've really got the bit between your teeth? It's a feeling of being truly alive, a passionate thing. For me, anyway.
I'm sorry, what is?
Look, she's like a beleaguered city at the moment. But you've got all the armory, James. You bide your time. And she let down the drawbridge and welcomed you with open arms. No bloodshed.
Well, Charlie, I think I'm in the mood for a bit of bloodshed. Jenny? Jenny? Ah, it's you, Sutton. Is Mrs. Hadleigh?
No, sir.
Is she telephoned? How long have you been back?
About an hour ago, sir. Nobody's telephoned.
Ah, I see. How did you get on then? Did you find Mrs. Drummond?
Mrs. Drummond is dead, sir.
Well, you'd better come and tell me all about it, hadn't you? Come.
Hello? Jen? Look, for God's sake, where the hell are you?
She went straight to the hospital in Cornwall, where she was treated before.
Dr. Fairbairn?
He was the last chance, she thought, but they told her he wasn't there, he was dead. Killed in an accident 2 years ago.
Yes, I know. I telephoned the hospital myself.
She took the car to a small cove, drove it onto the stones, left the door open, and the contents of her bag scattered. Otherwise, no one might have noticed till later.
Did they find her?
Search party. It's hard to imagine how you can just walk into the sea, knowing.
And Dr. Drummond?
He came to identify her, but I left before he arrived.
Well, I'm sorry, Sutton. I'll do everything I can to help, of course. And you mustn't blame yourself.
Were you expecting Mrs. Hadleigh back tonight, sir?
I'm not sure. Don't you wait up, will you?
Thank you, sir.
It's all over the village, you know. Terrible thrall, though not entirely unexpected.
Well, what exactly have you heard?
You want me to repeat gossip?
Yes, word for word. It's important, Helen.
Very well. Sutton and Marion Drummond ran away together to a love nest in Cornwall or somewhere. It all proved too much for her and she drowned herself.
Well, she drowned herself, that's true, but the rest is rubbish.
Well, you can't deny the liaison. And if you keep him on now, it looks as if you're condoning the whole thing. Especially when you think of what happened before.
Yes, sir.
Some coffee for her ladyship, Sutton, please.
Certainly, sir. And for you, sir?
No, not for me. I've got to go out.
Very good, sir.
He's a cool customer, I must say. Oh, I don't want you to get rid of him without a fair hearing. But I don't think you're aware of the details of the last few weeks.
And your ear is closer to the ground, is it, Helen?
I can't help it if I get told things.
No, I'm sorry. Well, if you don't mind, I'd rather deal with Sutton in my own time and in my own way.
Right. I was coming to dinner tonight. I suppose that's off.
No, of course it isn't. Why should it be? 8 o'clock as usual. Now, if you will excuse me, I'm awfully sorry, but I have got some work to do.
Well, where's Jennifer? It's her I rarely came to see. She promised to help me choose a colour scheme for my spare room weeks ago. She's not still in London.
Yes, I'm afraid she is.
Oh, but she'll be here tonight, won't she?
I wouldn't count on it.
You know where she is. She's phoned you, hasn't she?
It's not the point.
But you know where she is.
Look, she wants to be left alone. She wants to have some time to think.
What about? Now, listen, what exactly did she say? Here's my address and telephone number, but please don't tell anyone. Listen, she wants to be fetched.
She doesn't.
But of course she bloody does. That's what she's crying out for.
You don't know everything about women.
I know about silly little girls who think they're protecting their chums and are entirely missing the point. Now, give me the address.
What are you going to do with it?
I'm going to give it to her husband.
Oh, I see. Sucking up to the landed gentry, are we?
What?
Sorry I spoke.
Don't be so bloody facile. Give me that address!
Now, careful, Tony. I'm pregnant, don't forget. It's under Fraser.
Good afternoon, sir.
Hello, Sutton. Have there been any phone calls?
Just one, sir.
Mrs. Hadleigh?
No, Mr. Burrows.
Oh, Tony. What the hell does he want?
I asked if you would phone him back, sir. He did say it was important.
Yes, all right, I will.
I know this is not the time, sir, but I think sometime I have to discuss my future here.
Yes. Yes, I know. Well, I mean, I don't think we need make any hasty decisions, Sutton. Let's just see how things settle down, shall we?
Very good, sir.
We seem to be moving.
That's Shadow's Court, isn't it?
Yeah, Finborough Road. Famous for its transient, fly-by-night character. And we choose it as our place to settle down. What can I do for you?
Well, you've done the main thing. You've given me her address.
I thought you'd have gone straight there.
I wanted a little more information first.
Can't give you much. She phoned Lois at the dead of night. I was asleep, so I missed it. Not much given away this morning. I had to wrestle for the address.
Now, why the hell didn't she phone me?
Oh, I don't know. Panic, maybe? About the job?
Did she get it? Did she tell Lois?
Well, they must have talked about it, but Lois said nothing. Sorry.
Who are these people she's staying with, do you know?
Regent's Park. Not exactly my milieu. Lo probably knows him. She'll be back at 6 if you want to hang on.
Yes, well, hanging on is what I seem to have been doing, isn't it, really? And I've had enough.
Back to Yorkshire, let us stew.
That's what you do, is it?
Certainly. Me. But I always do the wrong thing. Want to take her a present?
Now, you keep that for your bride, will you?
Cancel the dinner. Yes, of course, sir. Well, naturally, sir. Well, I think baccarat roses would be best at this time of the year, sir. Yes. Shall I say 2 dozen? Yes. Very good, sir. Yeah. Goodbye, sir.
You know, you really are a prize bitch, aren't you?
I did phone. Yesterday afternoon when I said I would. When you said you'd be in.
I had to come to London. I didn't know where to get in touch with you. I phoned the Connaught, but of course you'd left.
What did you have to come to London for?
See some Germans about some tractors.
Oh, I see. That was important.
Yes, it was. To me.
Buy any?
What about your job?
Yes, I was wondering when you'd ask about that. It's mine if I want it.
Do you?
I have till noon tomorrow to let them know.
Or earlier, of course, if you've made up your mind.
Mm-hmm. Yes, I can call them at the Connaught at any time.
Right, what's stopping you now?
I haven't discussed it with my husband yet. I was going to try and get hold of you again this evening.
What is this place, anyway? I mean, who are these people? Do I know them?
Their name is Fraser. He is an ear, nose and throat specialist and she's Italian. They've gone off for 3 days and they've left me in charge.
In charge of what?
That mainly. She's a hyacinth Anne McCorn. Her name is Cynthia, aren't you, sweetheart? And she's worth £450. She's coming from a bout of enteritis. They want to show at the Alexandra Palace, you see, in December. That was one of the reasons that I couldn't come home.
Now, I'm not going to order you back. And I'm not going on my knees. We're going to stay here. And we're going to talk the whole thing through. And by 12 o'clock tomorrow, we're going to have the answer, final. No going back, right?
You needn't have bothered sending me back her roses, Sutton. Since Mr. Hadleigh can't entertain me, I brought Mr. Caldwell as my guest. We don't want all that fool to go to waste.
Very good, Milady. Good evening, sir. Good
evening, Sutton.
We'll settle ourselves comfortably in the library while you go and prepare the meal.
Dinner will be ready in an hour, Milady.
Yes, that's all right, Sutton. Thank you. Ah. Now, what'll you have to drink?
Well, a Scotch, Lady Helen, but I still think I should be taking you out to dinner, having arrived at your cottage uninvited.
As I said before, it's a pity to waste all that food. Besides, it's my revenge on James for standing me up. You see, it's the anniversary of my dear husband's death. I always hate being alone on that day. So I usually spend it with James.
I'm very sorry.
Oh, I'm not sentimental about it. Many years ago now. No, it's habit, really. And I'm a creature of habit.
So am I. So am I. You're sure James won't come back and discover us?
Not according to Sutton. As a matter of fact, this meal is a chance for him to redeem himself. You've...
Excuse me, m'lady, I'll just build up the fire.
Thank you, Sutton. Been going on in that quarter.
Yes, James did say something.
Well, more of that later. Tell me your news.
Did they ask about your marriage? It must have been a factor.
They don't care as long as the credentials are right. They don't care if you're running away. Though obviously they'd prefer it if you weren't and that your husband's happy and all that.
Which did you indicate?
All's well, of course.
They ask if I was going with you.
Ah, I said that you were a gentleman of independent means and that you might be joining me at some time. Because it's something we haven't discussed, isn't it?
What would I do?
Well, couldn't you find something? I mean, not just a fill-in, something you'd really like. It could be fantastic.
Anyway, there's too much going on at Melford. There are too many changes.
Changes? You could have fooled me. Yeah, hello?
Hello, Jen. It's Lois. Listen, Tony's given your address to James.
Yeah, I know he's here.
Oh, look, he really forced it out of me. I'm terribly sorry. I feel awful.
Doesn't matter, Lois. Don't worry. It's not the end of the world.
But look, what's going on? I mean, you okay?
Grimly battling.
What?
Bye, Lois.
No, Jen! Jen!
Lois flapping.
Yes, I gathered.
Now... Where were we?
We're at Melford. You want changes made. A new deal, all right? What kind of deal?
Well, tell me.
I don't know.
Well, God, we must define the problem.
No, it's not the point, don't you see? I mean, that's too easy. You can write me off as a spoilt, ungrateful cow. I mean, you believe that if that's what you want to believe, but that's not the reason we're here in this god-awful mess.
Then I give up.
So easily?
Well, I mean, there's no way we can talk anymore, is it? Look, every way I try...
Well, you just have to keep on looking.
Like hell I will.
Don't go!
You didn't know about the job.
No, I certainly didn't. James will put his foot down, of course. I'm surprised he's let it get this far. He rarely has been too accommodating with her.
Well, I don't like interfering, but good heavens, they're two intelligent people. But the fact is, I'm a bit out of touch in Liverpool. Now, you see more of them than I do. And I'm wondering what your reading of it all is, Lady Helen. James won't own up to there being any serious breach.
Well, I've grown very fond of Jennifer, you know, despite a few misunderstandings at the start. I think she has the makings of an excellent wife for James, and a dignified, if slightly unorthodox, mistress at Melford. But she really must realize that she's got a lot to learn. It's no good her complaining that things aren't to her liking. She should have thought of that before she went to the altar. She got to buckle to and accept the responsibilities that go with the privileges. She's greatly envied, you know. Half the females of the county would give their eye teeth to change places with her. So it's really hard for me to find too much sympathy for her discontent. And if she thinks she can change things at Melford, she's taken on more than she's bargained for.
I don't think she wants to change anything. More to find a place for herself in what's a bit of an unfamiliar setting.
Can't still be unfamiliar. After 8 months. And it isn't so different from anywhere else. Is it?
It's a bit different from her heritage.
I thought young people were supposed to be adaptable these days.
I've had 2 dreams recently, both about Melford. One was me looking at her, as though she were another woman. Your mistress, perhaps. Or your mother. I don't know, older anyway, with all the cards to play. Or maybe she was your wife, with me the mistress. The bit on the side, threatening her possession of you.
Is it female, a house?
La maison.
Le château. Tell me the other dream.
Mm-mm. It'd make you angry.
Tell me.
Well, it wasn't so much a dream, really, as a voice. A certainty that I'll never conceive at Melford.
That's stupid.
There now, you see, I said you'd be angry, but I can't help it.
Well, there is one thing we can do. We've got a place in town. I don't mean a PRT, I mean a real flat. We'll spend more time in London.
I might, but would you? That's dangerous.
You might even conceive. Then you'd have to come home. Baby, can't bring it up in a town flat, can you?
Why didn't we think of that before?
Because our problems go deeper than that, don't they?
I don't know, do they?
Oh, for God's sake, now, will you stop blaming Melford? It's not the house, it's you that's got to change.
Just me. No faults on your side.
I'm not talking about faults. It's attitude, a less rigid approach.
Well, how can I change? I've got no role to play.
You're my wife.
Yes, but, James, what do you expect from a wife? What do you want? Look, right at the beginning when we discussed this deal, we
talked...
Deal? Your word. You just used it. We talked about freedom, about not being tied and about being equal partners, but that was never on. Not when I got there, not once. It's the place that's rigid. It's not
we are partners. I've discussed things with you. I've shared every problem. I've consulted you on all the major issues.
No, you haven't. Oh. Not once. And every time I tried to assert my own personality, you just brushed me aside.
Well, of course, if you choose to see it as some sort of eternal contest with you being endlessly put down, I don't, and I'm damn sure you didn't. Not until you had to find a reason for your discontent. You haven't been sitting up there, bitterly counting the score. I don't believe it.
Well, it's not entirely a new thought, I assure you. Look, all I suppose I want is just some kind of victory that I can call mine. Is that too much to ask?
Yeah, but it's treating you like a child, isn't it? It's playing games.
OK. So what's wrong with playing games? Don't you like losing?
No, I don't mind losing. I just wouldn't be able to disguise it from you, would I? You'd rumble me, and God almighty, then there'd be hell to pay.
Well, please try me, because it's the only glimmer of hope that I can see. Yes, hello.
Hello, Jane. It's me again.
Yeah, hello, Lois.
Look, it's just that you sounded so awful last time. Are you all right?
It's all right.
Now, Lois, you're a dear, sweet, well-meaning girl, and you are the salt of the earth. But if you don't stop ringing this number, I am personally going to come round and I'm going to rip all the wires out of your house. And I'm going to rip all the wires out of your neighbours' houses. And I'm going to rip all the wires out of all the phone booths for miles around. Now, you know, this entire conversation has been conducted wholly on your terms. I mean, even the place is your choosing. You have happily got me defending the life that I've given you at Melford. And you're enjoying it. You're drawing comfort from it by the minute. Well, I'm sorry, but it's having entirely the opposite effect on me. It is growing abundantly clear by the second that you ought to pick up that phone and ring your Americans. I can't begin to match their offer.
If that's your idea of tactics...
What?
Look, I'm not going to get down on my knees and plead.
No tactics. I don't play games. I mean it.
What, you mean you're out of love with me?
I want you to be happy. If I can't make you happy, it's madness.
Would you sell Melford to save our marriage? Would you?
If I thought it was the only problem.
It is.
No. It's your excuse.
I thought you might be prepared to gamble.
Besides, Melford isn't just a house, you know. It's my way of life. It's been very rewarding to me this last year. It's a hell of a lot to give up.
Even for me?
For what we've got. At the moment.
Well, that's certainly on the line.
Will you feel the same? You're comparing America with what you think we've got.
You know, I don't think there's been a divorce in the Hadleigh family since the early part of the 19th century. Close shave sometimes. They were always avoided. These things better are. They always have such a demoralizing effect on people.
Well, not anymore, do they? A bit of scandal in high places, just what the doctor ordered.
Coffee, my lady.
Oh, thank you, Sutton. And a brandy for Mr. Caldwell. Is that right?
Yes, thank you. Excellent meal, Sutton. Excellent.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Do you mind if I smoke a cigar?
Please. Cream?
Please.
Oh, thank you, sir.
Redeemed himself?
Well...
Now, you mustn't worry about James. I've got every faith in him. And I'm sure they'll be as happy as I was with Jennifer's mother and you with your husband, whose memory we honor tonight.
Yes, I was happy, Charlie. But perhaps things were easier in those days.
Were they, Helen?
Fewer distractions, weren't there? Fewer alternatives. You see, one's sole purpose in those days for a girl was to get married. And once she'd achieved that object, for she devoted the whole of her energies to making it work. I mean, there was no question of a career or being independent. She simply got on with being married.
Well, education's changed all that. For the better, some would say.
Do you really think so?
Well, I wouldn't be too comfortable with a young woman of today, I must be honest. But getting back to James and Jennifer for a moment, assuming it is just a tiff that'll blow over, I'll put my yacht at their disposal. They never had a proper honeymoon.
That's a good idea.
Come on. Come on. Try this. There's a good girl.
What is it?
Sunflower seeds. Do you want feeding?
No. No, you have something.
I couldn't. If I do go to America, won't you feel an awful sense of failure?
Mistake, misjudgment, not failure.
Pretty big mistake. How would you face the tenants?
Oh, I think they'll be all right. I don't think they'll be hostile.
Oh, do we have to go on now? I've got the most awful headache.
All right, you go to bed. I'll come back in the morning. We'll go on then.
Well, don't be daft. Where are you going?
Well, I'm not going to sleep on this. Not with him watching me. And anything else might cloud the issue.
You said that once before, the night you proposed.
I was right, wasn't I?
I don't know. Where are you? Look at us now.
Is it narrow? Your bed?
Mm-hmm. But there's always theirs. And anyway, I'm so tired that it really doesn't matter. Want some coffee? Hey, coffee.
Oh, what time is it?
I don't know, about 7. You're shivering. Listen, I think you should have something to eat too, you know, all this driving up and down the motorways.
What have you been doing? Have you slept?
Not much, no. Just had a bath. Oh, it's a lovely day.
What are we going to do with it?
Have you got things to do?
Nope.
You going home then?
Yes. What are you going to do?
Well, we haven't decided anything.
Well, I don't think we're going to in this place, do you? Come home with me, Jen.
I don't think you want me to.
That's what you decided in your bath, is it?
Well, what's made you change your mind?
Well, I don't really know. I slept a bit. Fog seems to have cleared. Things don't seem so bad. I think your worries are largely imaginary. I mean, you haven't been going to America for several hours now, have you? I think it's just been an exercise in saving face, really.
No promises?
No.
What, just trust to luck?
And judgment.
Okay. Well, shall I go and pack then?
Okay.
Go on.
Jennifer.
Morning, Helen.
Are you all right?
Yes, yes, fine.
You look a little peaky.
A bit early, isn't it?
10:30?
Early for me.
Good morning, m'lady.
Oh, good morning, Sutton. Is Mr. Hadleigh up?
He's in the library, m'lady.
Thank you.
You wanted me, madam?
Yes. These shoes are supposed to be mended.
Oh, yes, I took them into the village myself.
Well, look at them. Absolute rubbish. The man must have been drunk or demented or something. You better take them into Leeds.
Very good, madam.
No, not at all, Charlie. It's really very nice to hear from you. Yes, she's here. Do you want to have a word with her? Hold on.
Me?
No, it's Charlie for Jennifer. Darling. Jenny, your father's on the telephone.
Okay, I'll take that here, thanks.
That girl's not in a very healthy state of mind.
She been upsetting you?
Not especially. It's her whole mood, her attitude. Ever since you brought her back from London after that job nonsense. I mean, if she's really so unhappy, perhaps she ought to go away for a little. Not mooch about, taking it out on all and sundry.
On you, huh?
On Sutton, just now. Ordering him about in a very high-handed manner.
Yes, well, let's leave it if you don't mind this morning.
But my dear boy, it's you I'm anxious about.
Well, don't be. You've no need to be.
You know, if you've got problems, it isn't any use bottling them up.
Look, if you've come for information, I'll give it to you. Now, we've had a bad time, yes, but we're over it now. It wasn't pleasant, and it knocked us both sideways. But I think I know how she feels. She'll be all right. She just needs a little gentleness, a little understanding, that's all.
Don't be too soft with her, James. Give a girl like that an inch and she'll... Well, I'm only going by what I saw. Anyway, it wasn't Jennifer I came to talk about.
Well, thank God for that.
It was Sutton. Now that poor Mrs. Drummond's funeral's over, what are you going to do about him?
Now, what do you want me to do about him?
Oh, don't be obtuse, dear. I've had people knocking on my door asking me when you're going to get rid of him.
What people?
Just ordinary people. Not cranks. Just ordinary people who are expecting a lead from Melford and don't seem to be getting it.
And you've joined that lobby, have you?
I haven't joined anything. I dislike scenes. I find myself sitting on the fence, which is most uncomfortable.
Now, what are you saying, Helen? I mean, do you want me to sack Sutton or do?
Dad's got to be in Hull on Monday. He's going to come and stay Sunday night. What was that about, Sutton?
Nothing, darling. Nothing at all. Helen's just leaving, aren't you, Helen?
What? Oh, yes, dear. Your father's coming, you say?
Yes, would you like to see him?
Oh, I'm afraid I can't come to dinner on Sunday night. I promised to call in at the vicarage for cold supper. But I'd... love to pop in for a drink, if I'm invited.
Yes, by all means.
Thank you, dear.
Was Helen complaining about me?
Nope.
Such loyalty.
She was complaining about Sutton.
Sutton?
And whether we should keep him on.
What does Sutton feel about it? Has anybody bothered to ask him?
Well, that's your province, really, isn't it?
He's your manservant. I'm so sorry.
What are you doing this afternoon?
Nothing much.
Well, I've got to go to Thirsk. It's a lovely day. Why don't you come with me? We could have dinner on the way back in the country.
Yeah, fine.
Excuse me, sir. Telephone. Herr Schimmel calling from London.
Yes, all right, sir. Now, I'll take it. I shan't be a moment.
Finished, madam?
Yes, thank you, Sutton. Sutton?
Yes, madam.
Is everything all right for you in the village?
Beg pardon, madam?
Well, I mean, are people making life difficult for you?
In what way?
Okay, don't want to talk about it.
It's the older generation, mostly. They'd known Dr. and Mrs. Drummond a long time. They knew the problems, although they didn't do much to help. I think they see me as a convenient scapegoat for their own guilt.
You've worked it all out, haven't you?
Well, it's the only thing that can explain their course of action.
What actions?
I have received some letters and phone calls. Not what you might call poisonous, but indicating their feelings about me. And, of course, in the village, one does notice the expressions on people's faces.
God, I've no idea. No,
they don't really bother me. They can't keep it up indefinitely.
But do you want to stay on here in this awful atmosphere?
Do you want me to leave?
No.
Does Mr. Hadleigh?
No. I don't think so.
I'm very happy here. But, naturally, if my presence is an embarrassment to you...
No, it isn't.
Fancy a trip to Leipzig?
What?
The Germans have offered us 10 days. All expenses paid, starting Monday. Thank you. To look at a tractor. We thought we'd take advantage of it and go to Prague, then on to Hungary.
Oh, well, then you must go to Carlovare. You know, the spa where Windsor took Mrs. Simpson between the walls.
And then come back and meet me in Malta. The yacht's there. Spend Christmas with me if you like.
No, I must spend my first Christmas here at Melford, then.
You don't have to.
I would like to. Thanks, anyway.
Oh, you'll enjoy it. Europe, I mean. I love Europe. So much more interesting than America.
Now, when were you last in America, Helen?
In 1937, with your uncle, my late husband.
It's changed a lot since then, Helen.
Yes, I'm quite aware of that, Jennifer. For the worse.
Not entirely.
That trouble with Sutton and the lady cleared up now, has it, James?
Not entirely.
What do you mean by that?
Oh, don't let's talk about it now.
But I'd like to, because Dad, I'm sure, could give us a lot of very useful hints on how to handle that, because he's spent a lifetime in worker management relations.
Well, so has James. And I think it's a matter for James to decide.
No, no, no. It's Jenny's concern as lady of the house.
What's it all about?
I'll tell you. Sutton got involved with the local doctor's wife. Well-known, unhappy marriage. But, you see, she had a mental problem and Sutton seemed to be able to get through to her briefly. But the strain of it drove her to run away and kill herself in the end. Sutton blamed by the older, more conservative, not to say entrenched members of the community. Melford expected to sack him and Melford won't.
Quite right, too.
Thank you.
I don't think you've been given quite a true picture, Charlie. James.
It's the truth as I've heard it, huh?
From Sutton's lips, I suppose.
No, no, no. I haven't discussed it with Sutton.
Well, isn't it time you did?
Well, I don't think he should, you see, because he might hear about the poison pen letters, and I think that would make James rather angry.
Poison pen?
Not to mention the phone calls.
Well, they're nothing to do with me.
Oh, I never said they were, Helen, but they're to do with someone, aren't they? My God, to think this is 1970 in good old England, and a manservant can be harassed and bullied by the so-called pillars of the community.
I really don't know what your daughter's talking about. I've never heard.
Listen, I've got the answer. It solves all problems. Why not let Sutton come over to me?
What, and work as a galley slave on the bloody yacht? Sutton stays.
No, in the family.
Bad luck, Dad. Good try, but he's staying here. He likes it here. He likes the house.
You're very silent, James. What have you got to say?
There's no question of Sutton leaving. And if your friends in the village say that it's all Mrs. Hadley's doing, you must tell them that Mr. Hadleigh agrees with his wife's decision. And will be very happy to meet anybody face to face who wants to interfere with the running of my house. Sutton is staying.
Your father would be amazed to hear you talk to me like that.
I've no doubt he would, Helen.
You know what you're doing, both of you. You're destroying a way of life. A way of life that's always given this country what little dignity it ever had.
But Helen, it's got to change. And if it depends for its survival on bigotry and hypocrisy, then the quicker it goes, the better.
Bigotry and hypocrisy? Well, that's not me, James.
I never said it was you. We're not arguing with you, Helen.
I don't want to see the old life go. What are we left with? People like me become the new aristocracy, and we don't want that.
Oh, you can't help it, Dad. You are already. Do you realise that by 1990 there won't be any more old colonels left, just peppery old businessmen?
Expressing the same views.
Oh, God, I hope not.
That's right. We can't go on the old terms. The challenge is to find acceptable alternatives.
Acceptable to who?
To you, to all of us, Helen. You included.
I'm sick of all this silly talk. It's giving me a pain.
Well, there now, Helen, don't upset yourself. We'll look after you.
Well, I think it's time I left for the vicarage anyway.
I'll see her out.
No, don't thank me. Sutton is your territory.
Yes. Oh, dear, did I offend her very badly?
No, I don't think so. You can't offend Helen, at least not for long. Mind you, I think you might have ruffled her feathers a bit.
Oh, thank you, Sutton. I'll see to that.
Very good, sir.
I don't think they meant what they said.
I'm quite certain they did. But I had to put up a bit of a fight.
Good, that's the spirit. And they seem all right, too. Our fears proved groundless.
For the time being.
I'll see you to your car.
Thank you, Charlie.
Oh, do you really think the end of all this is in sight?
Well, it's been in sight for years. It just won't quite lie down, that's all.
And we're going to Leipzig in the morning to buy tractors to preserve it. It's very confusing.
Do you feel better now?
I suddenly feel very happy. And rather proprietorial and totally corrupted.
Well, at least you feel happy.
They'll get us in the end, you know. They'll turn this place into a state home for the elderly with us the first incumbents.
Oh, I don't know. We haven't opened to the public yet. Let the lions in. There's a long way to go yet.
Do you think that anyone will mind very much if the son and heir is conceived in a Leipzig hotel?
Now, will anyone have to know?
Helen will be counting the days.
To hell with Helen.
Oh, sorry. I think she's all right now. You were a bit rough with her, you know. I've asked her to come and spend a few days on the yacht, a small party I'm assembling. Help patch things up. I don't like families squabbling.
Has she accepted?
She's thinking it over.
That's right, Sutton, put him in the car, will you? We're driving to the airport.
Very good, sir.
Mrs. Hadleigh has spoken to you, hasn't she? About staying on, I mean.
Yes, sir.
And you're happy about it, are you?
Very much, sir.
Good. Now, I want to know about any pressure put on you to leave, no matter who. You will tell me, won't you?
Yes, sir. But I'm sure it will quieten down.
Good. All right.
Anyone seen Dad?
Oh, he left very early, madam, for Hull. He didn't want to wake you, but he wished you bon voyage.
Ah. Oh. Are we ready?
All set.
Sutton?
Yes, madam.
Is everything going to be all right? I mean, you will be here when we get back, won't you?
You can rely on it, madam. Have a good trip.
Thank you. We will.